get into partnership, we don't look for true sharing opportunities, we don't take the time to listen, we don't take the time to define, and then we just blunder on. And we overspend, we duplicate the amount of times we must have gone to meeting and bumped into someone who's been doing something for 6 months that you've been wrestling with for the last 6 months yourself. And so I say, oh, you just need to talk to such and such. And it's like, but we don't do it. And that's what I mean. I don't think partnerships are set up correctly. And I go on record saying that I've met so few partnerships that are genuine partnerships. But also, a partnership doesn't necessarily mean equal in terms of distribution. And people can get quite touchy about that as well. So if two of us go into partnership, you know, is it necessarily a 50-50? It doesn't always have to be. As long as we're clear about what we're going into partnership for, though, and as long as there's a genuine understanding and sharing, and we've got some sort of values which we're basing on, then I think you can move forward. But it's keeping checking that and moving it forward. You know, the story I told earlier about a partnership that we just got into, where somebody all of a sudden said, oh, you've got something else. It's like, well, but what bit were you missing? Well, not. So, you know, where's the conflict? But also showing them how, from my point of view, they'll actually link back and enhance the program that we were about to start. I didn't think about it like that. And then they were comfortable. But I did say to them, I really welcomed that opportunity for them to raise it. Because that says to me, I think it's going to be a good partnership. We aren't always going to agree. But if there's that opportunity to communicate and to listen and to sit back, then I think that's going to move us forward.